It is the show that's really been picking up some steam lately from NBC's The Good Place. Please welcome Tiya Sircar. Tiya, I said your name right?
Yes, you totally did.
We were going through all the names she's been called that, you know, people just make
all kinds of things.
It's just a mess. So, Tiya, this show, people are starting to like The Good Place just more and more. It's catching steam. Why do you think people are just really gravitating to the show now?
Well, for one, I think season one is on Netflix now, and it was like perfect timing because people are like binge watching it, you know, in preparation for season two. But I think in general, I love that the premise is so different from anything else on television, and it's funny, and I mean, I think their writing is like some of the smartest writing on TV. And also there's kind of like a message, you know, it's like this overarching idea of what does it mean to be a good person and sort of like self-reflection. And I like that element because it's not just about like laughs and, you know, funny jokes. It's there's like a message to it as well.
It's the fight between good and evil and all this stuff with, of course, the comedic twist. The table reads, that's got to be just a big old crazy hot mess, right?
No, it's not a mess at all. Somehow it's so funny. Well, it's funny. I say like, I read these scripts and I hear the jokes in my mind. I mean, the writing is so wonderful that it doesn't take much. Like, the jokes are right there. And I always think I know what Kristen's character, Eleanor, how it sounds. And then we go to the table read and then she just does it in such a way that I'm like, oh no, that's how that joke sounds.
Yeah.
It's like, it's so, she's there between Ted Danson and Kristen Bell. It's like, you know, just comedy chops are like the standard is high.
And by the way, no spoilers because I'm still on season one.
Then I will not tell you what's happening in season
two. But there's something big.
Yeah, my buddy who is super jaded, he can't impress this guy. And he came to me, I didn't solicit anything. You have to see The Good Place.
Oh, good.
And he said season two is going to really mess with your brain.
Oh,
so is that inaccurate?
Yes, that's what our that's our goal is to mess with your brain.
Okay.
Much in there. So
if you've gotten through season one, you sort of, I won't say what, but you know kind of where we're at and what's really going on. And so season two, there's like, well, I don't know, I don't want to say too much, but there's a reboot and things are different now. I'm doing different things on the show than I was in the first season, and it's like sort of,
I think I know what you're talking about, but I'm like,
I don't want to tell you then, but it's diametric. I'll just say for me, my character is like, I've done a 180, so that's all I'll say.
Well, we have a clip of The Good Place, so you guys take a peek at this.
You gotta admit, things are going pretty well since I took over.
Certainly a lot smoother lately. And based on my surveillance, our four humans don't suspect anything.
Yeah, because we're killing it.
You sure are. Here are the torture ideas you asked me to write up for next week.
Ugh, so long. You're not supposed to be torturing me. From now on, make all your memos one page max with pictures. Also, Quinston over here already came up with a sick idea for how to torture Tahani. Tell him, babe.
We're gonna have Tahani throw a party for Gunner's birthday, but no one will show up because we'll also be throwing a party and it'll be way better.
Boom!
Where do you get that? Okay. All right, well, that's that. I have to get through these. Binge watching.
I think you might kind of know.
I know what's happening. You're an evil person now.
Yeah, right. Something has changed.
Yeah, things are different now. Also, I've never seen that clip before, so that was new for me.
It's a pretty good show. You should watch it. You have another show real quick called Alex, Inc. Can you give me a quick summary on that one?
Yes. It will premiere in the spring. It's for ABC. I play Zach Braff's wife. He executive produces the show, directs a ton of the episodes, and stars on it. And it's based on a real life story about a man who has a wife and two kids and a very successful career, and decides that he's going to quit his job and go out and start a podcast company because he wants to tell stories that he thinks are meaningful to people that might change their lives.
My life story.
Is that right?
He's a podcaster over here.
Would you like to plug your podcast, Frank?
Well,
Frank Buckley
Frank Buckley interview.
Oh, all right. Well, maybe it's based on a true story about a real life person who did this. And so we are basically following the story of him going out and basically like pursuing his dream as a person that's in his late 30s with a family to
just
support.
Just like Frank.
Yeah.
I mean, the parallel.
Hopefully this show resonates with you. But so, it's like a little bit of a workplace comedy, a little bit of a family comedy. We sort of toe the line. So there's a little bit of something for everyone.
Kind of like Frank. Alex Inc., look out for that, of course. Do not miss season 2 of NBC's The Good Place, Thursdays 8:30 on NBC. Tiya Sircar, fist bump to make it official. Man!
Thank you, Tiya.
There we go. Thank you, Tiya.